Hey, it's Derek from ForeGolf Custom here, and today we're talking about custom fitting and TrackMan. We've been working with TrackMan for well over 10 years now, and for us, it's the best ball flight technology that we can find. It allows us to get so many different metrics about the ball, the way the customer delivers the club to the ball, how it hits, a number of different metrics that we can then use to understand what's the best club based on the individual golfer. We really like it as well because it gives us real-time ball flight measurements when we're seeing balls out here on the driving range. So listen, I'm going to give you a quick insight into when I'm fitting, what are the kind of key things about the TrackMan data that I'm looking at, and how do I use that to figure out what's the best type of club or the setup of the club. Let's talk about drivers first. Okay, so today's driver is a really low spinning. What I mean by that is, with all the new carbon fiber and the way that the drivers are all now designed, the spin rate from the club head when you strike it is spinning very low. So it's really important that you get this spin rate just right for the type of golfer that you're working with, and you're using the settings on the head or the loft on the club to get the right type of spin rate. What do you mean by the right type of spin rate? Well, okay, let me show you something on TrackMan. Come here. So this is a golfer we worked with this week. You can see here from the spin rate, this is his own driver here, okay? So decent enough ball speed, decent enough club speed, but you see the spin rate. Now he is a little bit negative in terms of the tack angle, but you see how high the spin is. Now watch what happens when I change the driver and kind of manipulate that spin rate. So I've dropped the spin rate down 2100. If we go before, you can see straight away, he's only hitting it around 232 yards when we move the spin rate. Straight away up to 269, we've lowered the spin rate, he's a little bit more up on it, but right away we've got a low spin, we've got a decent launch, and the distance is way up. So that's really important to understand. Spin rate equals the right type of distance. So remember that when you're picking out the drivers. All right, let's talk about loft to suit launch angle. Because these drivers are spinning really low, I'm using loft a lot differently now than I was maybe 5 or 6 years ago. Loft used to be how we would manipulate spin, but because spin is so low, I'm now using loft to generate launch angle. So this is the golden triangle is ball speed, launch angle, and spin rate. Get the launch right by using the right loft and the way that you're setting the weight at the back and the way that you're maybe manipulating some of the hosels to a more sort of upright or more a higher setting, you'll start to see that ball flight going really high and really long because you're launching it high and spinning it low. Shafts. I get this question all the time. What flex or type of shaft should I be using? Most people think that it's rated to the way that they swing or the speed. That's a little bit of it, but really the type of shaft that you're using will have a big effect on the consistency of your drives. But also remember, if you're gonna start shortening your shaft length, remember to balance the club properly. Because we build the clubs here in workshop, we can manipulate the weight of the driver. Don't just buy a standard driver, lob an inch off the shaft, because the swing weight's gonna drop, it's gonna ruin your tempo, it's gonna ruin the shaft flex, and basically you're gonna have to put that driver in the bin. Build it from at the right length from the start. When I talk about the right length, it's to do with dispersion and consistency. Again, actually, let me just show you real quickly here. So again, from this guy that we had earlier, the white one here in the front, this is his dispersion on his own driver. It's a standard length driver, it's about 45.5 inches. The driver lengths are much longer now. When we've shortened the driver to get a more consistency, you can see he's consistently hitting it more into the face. The consistency is way up, much more centered, much more together, much more finding the fairway better, and way better than his original dispersion. So remember, shaft length is critical, but get the shaft length right from the start so that you get the right centers and the right consistency. Okay, last piece of information, angle of attack. You saw earlier on the sheet when I was showing you about that driver, negative attack angle is not good for low spinning drivers because it creates this all sorts of difficult ball flight. So work on getting that launch angle more positive. Also work with the way that the driver is set up to suit that. So use loft to create a better angle of attack. Use the shaft flex and the way that it works with the driver to create a better launch angle, and work on that positive. So on the up, ball in the air, launching better with the lower spin, and manipulate those settings to get more of a sort of a higher launching, lower spinning driver, and I can guarantee you, you'll see those drivers going much further and much more consistent.